Hey guys, welcome to this video. This is the final conclusion video for the Zen Installer Ice Linux install that we did previously, and I've been using it for a week. Right after this. So here we are on the desktop. So I was running this for a week. So Arch Linux, beautiful system, of course. I've been using it for several years by now. Currently I'm running Pop OS, but before that I was always running Arch Linux. We ended up with the kernel 5.6.14, 786 packages, so it's very low in the number of packages that being installed on the system. I only installed my preferred packages. We're running the theme Arc Dark and the Papyrus icon theme, so it's beautiful. So as you can see here, nice Papyrus icon theme. We're running the Lanva theme overall, so with the purple and the blue, perfectly matching with my nice wallpaper. So I think that's it's looking very good. Yeah, after my first initial issues with not having a console installed and not having Dolphin installed, when I fixed that, everything went very smoothly. Installing packages you have seen in the previous video, no problems at all. It's very fast. It's more lightweight than I was expecting. It's a very good system. Arch, I really like it. The Zen installer, I'm very confused by, if you do with the KDE applications, and you get a lot of packages installed that you don't need. If you do the minimal install with just the Plasma desktop, you don't get the basics that you need to be able to work with the system. So you have to install a different terminal emulator instead of the default console. You don't get a file browser, and I know if you are running Arch, you can make everything look and feel the way you want it, but those are two basic things that I think you need on a system. Why would you install Office during your installation and Firefox if you cannot even browse for your files? So you have to go into a third-party terminal emulator to be able to work with it. So those are the things that I didn't really like. Overall, if you install Plasma without all the packages on Arch Linux straight away, you get the same thing. You don't have Dolphin and you don't have console installed. But that's just because, like, if you do a really plain Arch install, you have to select everything you want on your system. So I can maybe relate to it, but on the other hand, if you do something like a Zen installer and you want to make it easy for people to work with the system, I think those are the two basic things that you need to be installing on your system from scratch. So after I fixed that, everything went very smoothly. So let's go over the Geekbench scores and then the memory usage. So Geekbench single core 783. So yeah, that's on par. Multi-core 1538. It looks like the Arch installers 1523, Manjaro 1542, Manjaro Gnome 1512. So all the Arch based installs are basically the same. Memory 544, so yeah, you can see here it's on par with all the KDE environments, so there's no problem. But then boot time after the installation, clean boot time 10.763. so KDE Neon was the fastest, but now it is Arch Linux file and installer. So because it's just a plain system, nothing is installed on it, it's just pure Arch Linux, it's very fast in boot time. Okay, so let's close this one. And as I said, I would rather do with the ArchFry script, but or just a plain Arch Linux install, because yeah, it's not that difficult to install Arch, but this helps. But it's not the one that I would recommend. I would recommend the ArchFry or Archman to install Arch instead of the Xen installer. But that's me. Some people might like it otherwise, but that's just me. So let's go over and select the OS that we're gonna run for the next week. So we're gonna do the shuf. -n1 on the distros.txt, and we're gonna run Amarok Linux. So let me zoom in a bit. Amarok Linux. It's not a known system to me, so it will be my first look at it as well. So in the next video, I'll be installing Amarok Linux, and then I'm gonna tweak it again in the second video, and I'll be using it for another week. And then I will make my final conclusions on it. Guys, again, if you have a suggestion for an operating system that I should run for a week, please let me know in the comments. After this one, I only have two on left that were recommended to me. And else I'm just gonna be going over the known distros, to be able to check those kind of things. But then the distro shuffle will end. So we only have two left. So 3 weeks in total. So if you have any suggestions, let me know. And in the meantime, guys, have fun with Linux. Hope you like this video. Please subscribe. We're almost at 1,000. And if you have any suggestions for my videos, let me know. And just see you in the next one. Have fun, guys. Bye for now.